Morning students, we started this lesson change around us. Yesterday we discussed some types of changes. Today we will see further. See, there is a next type of change, that is a desirable change. See, this desirable change, this desirable word is new for you. So what is a desirable? See, it is the meaning is very simple. Desirable change means what? See, the definition is written here. Changes which are useful to us are called desirable changes. Means those changes are useful to us are known as desirable changes. Or in another way, you can say those changes are good. Means which changes do you like? That all the changes are known as desirable. See, the word is different, but the meaning is very simple. Which are the changes which are useful for us? For example, cooking of food. See, your mother is preparing food. Then that changes is good. Food is very important for us. Yes, it is. Means we are eating food, then only we are getting the energy. So this cooking of food is useful for us. Okay, so these is an example of a desirable change. Like that, there are so many examples are there. See, ripening of fruits. If you will take the raw one banana, okay, and another one, it is a totally ripened banana. Then which one is a very tasty? The ripened one. Okay, so these the changes which have, some changes are naturally occur, some are man-made. In the cooking of food, it is artificial, means it is a man-made change, but ripening of fruits are natural changes. So those changes are useful for us, and those changes, do you like that? All the changes are known as a desirable change. Okay, now next one is there, that is a undesirable change. See, undesirable change is a totally opposite of desirable change. Here the undesirable change means what? The changes which are not useful for us are called undesirable changes. Means some changes are there that are not useful for us. For example, spoiling of food. Now spoiling of food, do you know that? Okay, that is a good for us. That is a good change. Do you like that? No, because it is a wastage of food and it is not useful for us. So like that, the changes are known as a undesirable change. This is one example. Then another example, breaking of mirror. Now suppose you are playing and by mistake the mirror is broken. Okay, then that is a good change. No, it is a not good change. Okay, it is not useful for us. So that are some examples of undesirable change. Do you understand the desirable and undesirable change? Okay, in this today's period, after this video, you have to write the 5 examples of desirable change and 5 examples of undesirable change. See, you just observe in your surrounding which changes. See, so many examples are there. Okay, which changes are useful for you? Write that in desirable changes and observe it, and which changes are not useful for you, write in undesirable change. Okay, now the next type of change that we will see, that is a physical change. See, physical change, and one more it is a chemical change we will see, but first we will discuss about physical change. Now physical change means what? See, reversible change we learned yesterday. Okay, the mostly the similarities are there. In physical state, what happens? See, a change occurs only in physical state. Size and shape are called physical changes. Means any change, if it is occur in that particular substance, physical state. Now physical state means what? Change of physical state means, physical state means what? Change occur in, means one state to another, solid to liquid, liquid to solid, solid liquid to gas, that. Okay, then size and shape are called physical changes. For example, now just you rethink, means revise that, which is the example is suitable for this. See, most of the times we learn this example, that is the water converted into ice. See, water is a original substance. Okay, then water is in which state? Liquid state. Okay, when you will get in a freezer after some times it will converted into ice. Then totally the state is a change. See, physical state is a change. Water converted into ice. So water first is in which state? Liquid state. Okay. And when it converted into ice, that time it is solid state. So here the physical state is a change, liquid to solid. So this is the which example? Physical change means original substance we are getting the back. And see, after some time, after the cooling with the temperature increase, after that is ice is again converted into water. So water, the original substance we are getting back. So this is the example of physical change. One more, see, water on heating it is converted into steam. Steam now it is which state? It is in a gaseous state. Okay, so this is also one example of physical change. Now it is a temporary change, means this change means temporary change, it is not a permanent change. After some times we are getting the original substance back. It is a temporary change. Then no new substance is formed. In this, any new substance is formed? No, here is no new substance formed. See, water, the characteristics means the properties of water remain same. It will be converted into ice also. Okay, no new substance is formed. Suppose in water, if you will add the salt, then here the totally the test change. So that is not example of a physical change. Here no any new substance is formed and it is a temporary change. For example, see, this one is a sponge. Okay, this is sponge. If you will press it, if you will apply the pressure, the size is a change. So, and then if you will release the pressure, again it will come into the original shape. So this is the example of physical change. Do you understand a physical change? See, these all the points, whatever the written on the blackboard, you have to write in your chemistry notebook. So these are the some points which are very important in the physical change. And physical and chemical change, one separate lesson is there in class 7th NCERT textbook. When you will do this study, you just refer 7th standard NCERT textbook. Now the next change we will see, that is chemical change. Okay, these all the points you write in your chemistry notebook. See the next change.
For milk, when example milk
consisting of iron. Here also the new substance is formed. This is also the example of chemical change. Okay, so many, if you will observe, so many changes are there. So today what you have to do, just read the information related about the physical change and chemical change and write 5 examples of each type of change. Okay, so the next points we will continue in next period. Thank you.